Rapier. Rapier, or espada opera, is a loose term for a type of slender, sharply pointed sword. With such design features, the rapier is optimized to be a thrusting weapon, but cutting or slashing attacks were also recorded in some historical treatises like Capo Ferro's Grand Simulacro in 1610. This weapon was mainly used in early modern Europe during the 16th and 17th centuries. The term rapier is also applied by archaeologists to a type of Bronze Age sword, however, the Bronze Age weapon is not related to the later Renaissance weapon. The word rapier generally refers to a relatively long-bladed sword characterized by a protective hilt which is constructed to provide protection for the hand wielding the sword. Some historical rapier samples also feature a broad blade mounted on a typical rapier hilt. The term rapier can be confusing because if these hybrid weapon can be categorized as a type of broadsword. While the rapier blade might be broad enough to cut to some degree, it is designed to perform quick and nimble thrusting attacks. The blade might be sharpened along its entire length or sharpen only from the center to the tip. Pallavicini, a rapier master in 1670, strongly advocated using the weapon with two cutting edges. A typical example would weigh and have a relatively long and slender blade of or less in width, or more in length and ending in a sharply pointed tip. The blade length of quite a few historical examples, particularly the Italian rapiers in the early 17th century, is well over and can even reach. The term rapier generally refers to a thrusting sword with a blade longer and thinner than that of the so-called side sword but much heavier than the small sword, a lighter weapon that would follow in the 18th century and later, but the exact form of the blade and hilt often depends on who is writing and when. It can refer to earlier spotted alato and the similar espada opera, through the high rapier period of the 17th century through the small sword and dueling swords, thus context is important in understanding what is meant by the word. The word rapier is a German word to describe what was considered to be a foreign weapon, though it was produced within the Holy Roman Empire. The word rapier was not used by Italian, Spanish, and French masters during the heyday of this weapon, the term spada, espada, and ape being instead the norm. Because of this, as well as the great variation of late 16th and 17th century swords, some like Tom Leone simply describe the rapier as a straight-bladed, two-edged, single-handed sword of that period which is sufficient in terms of both offense and defense, not requiring a companion weapon. To avoid the confusion of lumping all swords together, some categorize such swords by their function and use. For example, John Clements categorizes thrusting swords with poor cutting abilities as rapiers, and swords with both good thrusting and cutting ability as cut and thrust swords. Some, however, look at the rapier in its entire timeline and see that it never truly fits into any single definition. Across Europe, the weapon changed based on culture and the fighting style that was prescribed, be it Italian, Spanish, or some other instruction on the weapon sews, so that lengths, widths, hilt designs and even the lack or placement of an edge or edges differed at the same time. One might wear a rapier with a swept hilt and edges on the same day as another might wear one with a cup hilt and an edgeless blade. Rapiers often have complex, sweeping hilts designed to protect the hand wielding the sword. Rings extend forward from the crosspiece. In some later samples, rings are covered with metal plates, eventually evolving into the cup hilts of many later rapiers. There were hardly any samples that featured plates covering the rings prior to the 1600s. Many hilts include a knuckle bow extending down from the crosspiece protecting the grip, which was usually wood wrapped with cord, leather or wire. A fat pommel secures the grip to the weapon and provides some weight to balance the long blade. Various rapier masters divided the blade into two, three, four, five or even nine parts. The forte, strong, is that part of the blade closest to the hilt. In cases where a master divides the blade into an even number of parts, this is the first half of the blade. The debole, weak, is the part of the blade which includes the point and is the second half of the blade when the sword is divided into an even number of parts. However, some rapier masters divided the blade into three parts, in which case the central third of the blade, between the forte and the debole, was often called the medio, mezzo or the terzo. Others used four divisions or even 12. The ricasso is the rear portion of the blade, usually unsharpened. It extends forward from the cross piece or quillion and then gradually integrates into the thinner and sharper portion of the blade. There was historical disagreement over how long the ideal rapier should be, with some masters, such as Thibaut, denigrating those who recommended longer blades. Thibaut's own recommended length was such that the cross of the sword be level with the navel when standing naturally with the point resting on the ground. Rapiers are single-handed weapons and they were often employed with offhand bucklers, daggers, cloaks and even second swords to assist with defense. A buckler is a small round shield that was used with other blades as well, such as the arming sword. In Capo Ferro's Gran Simulacro, the treatise depicts how to use the weapon with the rotella, which is a significantly bigger shield compared with the buckler. Nevertheless, using rapier with its parrying dagger is the most common practice, and it has been arguably considered as the most suited and effective accompanying weapon for the rapier. Even though the slender blade of rapier enables the user to launch quick attack at a fairly long and advantage distance between the user and the opponent, on the protective hilt can deflect the opponent's blade when he or she uses rapier as well. The thrust-oriented weapon is weakened by its baited cutting power on relatively low maneuverability at a closer distance, where the opponent has safely passed the reach of the rapier's deadly point. Because of such insufficient cutting power and maneuverability at this situation when the opponent passes the deadly point, this scenario leaves opening fourth opponent to attack the user. Therefore, some close-range protection for the user needs to be ensured if the user intends to use the rapier in an optimal way, especially when the opponent uses some slash-oriented sword like a saber or a broadsword. A parrying dagger not only enables the users to defend in this scenario in which the rapier is not very good at protecting the user, but also enables them to attack in such close distance. The rapier was first developed around 1500 as the Spanish Espada Opera, or dress sword. The Espada Opera was a cut-and-thrust civilian weapon for self-defense in the duel, while earlier weapons were equally at home on the battlefield. Throughout the 16th century, a variety of new, single-handed civilian weapons were being developed. In 1570, the Italian swordmaster Signor Rocco Bonetti first settled in England, advocating the use of the rapier for thrusting as opposed to cutting or slashing when engaged in a duel. Nevertheless, the English word rapier generally refers to a primarily thrusting weapon, developed by the year 1600 as a result of the geometrical theories of such masters as Camillo Agrippa, Ridolfo Capo Ferro, and Vincenzo Saviolo. The rapier became extremely fashionable throughout Europe with the wealthier classes, but was not without its detractors. Some people, such as George Silver, disapproved of its technical potential and the dueling use to which it was put. The etymology of the word rapier is uncertain. Charles Dufresne, Sieur du Quinge, in his Glossary Immediate et Infamy Latinitatis, cites a form raparia in from a Latin text from 1511. He mentions an etymology deriving the word from the Greek rho alpha pi zeta epsilon iota nu to strike. However, Walter William Skeet suggested that rapier may derive from raspier, a poker, and that this may be a contemptuous term developed by older cut and thrust fencers for the new weapon. The most probable root of this term, however, appeared to be from the Spanish roper that comes from ropa, or elegant dress, thus a dress sword. Allowing for fast reactions, and with a long reach, the rapier was well suited to civilian combat in the 16th-17th centuries. As military-style cutting and thrusting swords continued to evolve to meet needs on the battlefield, so did the rapier continue to evolve to meet the needs of civilian combat and decorum, eventually becoming lighter, shorter and less cumbersome to wear. This is when the rapier began to give way to the calicimardi, itself being later superseded by the small sword, which was later superseded by the épée. Noticeably, there were some war rapiers that feature a relatively wide blade mounted on a typical rapier hilt during this era. These hybrid swords were used in the military or even in battlefield. A Gustav II Adolf's carried sword that was used in the Thirty Years' War is a typical example of war rapier. By the year 1715, the rapier had been largely replaced by the lighter small sword throughout most of Europe, although the former continued to be used, as evidenced by the treatises of Donald McBain, P. J. F. Gerard and Domenico Angelo. The rapier is still used today by officers of the Swiss Guard of the Pope. Classical fencing schools claim to have inherited aspects of rapier forms in their systems. In 1885, fencing scholar Edgerton Castle wrote, "There is little doubt that the French system of fencing can be traced, at its origin, to the ancient Italian swordsmanship, the modern Italian school being of course derived in an uninterrupted manner from the same source." Castle went on to note that the Italians had preserved the rapier form, with cup, pardon, and quillens, but with a slender quadrangular blade. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.